Good evening, all of you. I'm Jitendra Kumar. I'm here for supply some important questions for economics at standard 12 for those students who is going to appear upcoming examination conducted by CBSE. First, I will provide you notes, chapter by chapter, some selected questions in 12 video. Today is my first video and I capture only first chapter of macroeconomics, all levels of economics at standard 12 level is divided into two portions. First, microeconomics, and second part is macroeconomics. The first part consists of six chapters, and second part macroeconomics also consists of six chapters. Total number of chapter we have to study in the syllabus of economics is 12. So now today I will start with the first chapter, economics. Briefly I will define something, and two important questions I will discuss. And first of all, I want to say something to you. Don't lose your heart as your examination is approaching, because I will give some tips along with my video to upgrade your level of confidence and handle your examination paper very well. And if you like, never forget to click the button of like, and click the button of description to get my notes. And finally, never forget to subscribe if you want to get next remaining 11 video. Now I start with first of all, let us start with the definition of economics. It is a very difficult to define economics in few words, but briefly, I would like to try my level hard to define economics. Economics is a science in which we study rational management of, judicial management of our scarce resources to satisfy unlimited our want. This is the definition of economics in my opinion. First question, many questions setting in your mind. What are the nature of economics? Economics is the science, but what type of science? There are two type of science. First, positive science and normative science. Positive science is a concern with what is it is, like physics, chemistry. If somebody asks you any questions, like what are the causes of unemployment in our country, why prices are rising, etc., are included under the purview of positive science. But normative science is a concern what should be. It pass some value judgment commitment to economics problems. Like that, what it concerned with what should be, what suggestion should be made to reduce unemployment in our country, like that, was demonetization justified, etc. Now, nature of economics I have briefly described. Now it is a time to learn about the subject matter of economics. Broadly, economics is divided into two groups. First, microeconomics and macroeconomics. Microeconomics study economics activities at individual level. Okay? Whereas, macroeconomics study economics activity and problems at the aggregate level. It describes whole of economics. Subject matters. Now, question one of question, there is the differences between economics. I will try to define economy. An economy is system in which people get livelihood through process of production, consumption, in exchange, investment, etc. Now, type of economics. Basically, there are three type of economics. First, capitalist economics, socialist economics, and mixed economics. And I would like to try to define each of these three types of economics. First, capitalist economics. All the economics decisions are taken by private player. Here, factor of production are owned by private player. Here, products, economics activities, production activities are guided by self-interest and profit motive. This is the characteristic of capitalist economics like USA economics. Now, socialist economics, all the economics decision. In socialist economics, all the economic decisions are taken by authorized central government. Yeah, any economics where all the economic decisions are taken by the government, which is known as the socialist economics, like China-Russian economics. Next move, mixed economics. In mixed economics, private player as well as government also participate in the process of production. All the economic decisions here are taken by either government or private economics player, and sometimes together government and private economic player also take major economics decision, like Indian economics. Now, it is a very important question for upcoming examination 2019 for economics paper. What are the central problem of economics? At 12 standard level, only three problem can be considered is the central problem of economics. What to produce, how to produce, and for whom to produce. The first, let us start with how to produce. How to produce. It is a central problem of economics. Central problem of economics. And economics. Central problem of economics. What to produce? How to produce, and for whom to produce, for whom to produce. How, what to produce is a directly related to better utilization of our limited resources. What to produce? Every economics has a decide which goods and services are to be produced and what should be its optimal quantity. Economics has a decide whether to produce consumer good or capital good. And how to produce is a directly related to technique of production. There are two types of production. First, production technique of choice of production technique. It is related to choice of production technique. There are two kinds of choice of production technique. First, labor intensive production technique, and another is a capital intensive production technique. In labor intensive production techniques, in which labor are used more than capital. It becomes suitable for those countries having huge population like India. And in capital intensive production technique in which capital are used more than labor, it becomes very suitable for USA country, because USA is now having huge resources of capitals. And economics has to decide which production technique to adopt to maximize social welfare. And now final is for whom to produce. It is directly related to distribution of our rational income among the factor of the production. In economics there are five factor of production: land, labor, capital, management and entrepreneur. Labor get rent, labor get wages, capital get interest, management gets salary, and entrepreneur finally get either loss or profit. It completely depend upon how his business will go in the future. Economics has to decide how much share of national income will go to this factor of production who has contributed in generating of national income. Now, another important question is production possibility curve. Production possibility curve. Production possibility curve is a curve. So various alternative production possibility of two goods can be produced with given resources and given technology. It is also known as a transformation curve, production possibility frontier. And I will draw a table to make this point very clear to all of you. First, some assumptions are made. First, available factor of production are fixed. Production technique remain unchanged. All the factors are not equally efficiently employed in the production of all commodity. Like first, a table I can make here combinations. Yeah, it is a curve representing combination of two goods can be produced with given technology and resources. Combinations A, B, C, D, E. Commodity X, commodity Y, MOC, marginal opportunity cost. It is also known marginal rate of substitution. Formula is delta Y by delta X. Zero, one, two, three, four, five. 15, 14, 12, 9, 5, 0.
One by one, two by one, three by one, four by one, five by one.
It is the marginal rate of substitution, marginal opportunity cost. Here, if we plot this table, combination A is made of 1 unit of x commodity plus 14 unit of commodity y. If we plot this table on graph, we get like that. O, X, Y. Here, commodity X, commodity Y, 2, 4, 6. 2, 4, 6, 7, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. First 14, second 12, third 9, 5, 5. If we plot this table, I have converted this table into diagrammatic represent. We get a curve like that. It is a downward sloping from left to right. This it is so because if we increase production of one commodity, we have to decrease production of another commodity. And second, it is a concave to origin. This is because marginal opportunity cost, marginal rate of substitution tend to rise. That's the why it gets the shape of concave. Okay, and tomorrow I will give you next video, fourth chapter number two in economics paper, and I wish you best of luck and get better to best marks in your examination. Thank you very much.